It's time to step away from the toil and trouble in the crypto market today, and maybe that's something to be thankful for, because of course, for our American viewers, it's Thanksgiving, and I hope you have a happy one. So let's focus instead on one of the tokens that you may not be so familiar with, and this one is a bull, not a turkey. Every week, we'll be taking a closer look at a crypto project that we think is interesting. And since this week is Digital Securities Week on CryptoBriefy.com, we thought we'd look at Polymath. So, what is Polymath? Well, it's a platform like Ethereum, but instead of creating ICO utility tokens, it offers a way to buy equity in a company. This is commonly known in crypto as a security token offering, or STO. One of the biggest differences between an ICO and an STO is very simple. An STO has to be 100% compliant with the SEC regulations. Now, if you're ready for some irony, Polymath raised its money via, guess what? An ICO. That's not as weird as it sounds. I promise. The Polymath ICO was the first to be registered with the Securities and Exchange Commission, or SEC, and to be fully SEC compliant. Over $59 million was raised during a private token sale to accredited investors. Since then, Polymath has been one of the pioneers in the evolving digital securities arena, and it is still a top 100 crypto token. But like the rest of the market, it has suffered in the bear market, and its current market cap is just $42 million at a price of around 15 cents. Now, does this make it a good deal? That may depend on whether you believe STOs are the future of crowdfunding. Is it being used? Well, yes. Some of the projects currently building on the Polymath platform include T0, Mint Health, Coral, and Block Estate. Taking a closer look at these tokens, T0 is Overstock's blockchain-based subsidiary that is hoping to build a better Wall Street infrastructure on the blockchain. Mint Health is a healthcare solution that puts patient medical information on the blockchain. Coral is an investment platform that lets businesses offer revenue sharing instead of equity. Another ironic twist on Polymath's focus on securities. Block Estate is a fund using the blockchain to tokenize real estate transactions. So Polymath is a blockchain that includes security issuers, investors, and developers to ensure full KYC AML compliance for issuing financial securities. You can trade Poly on several crypto exchanges like Binance, KuCoin, BitRex, and Kyber, but you can't actually buy security tokens themselves without being an accredited investor. If you want to know more about Polymath, you can read about it on CryptoBriefing.com's Coin Guide, along with dozens of other tokens and currencies. I'll leave you with a thought for the day, and this one is from Abigail Johnson, the CEO of Fidelity Investments, which has $2.5 trillion under management. She says, "I love this stuff, Bitcoin, Ethereum, blockchain technology, and what the future holds." Well, me too. And let's hold on to that thought until this weekend when I'll see you again.